A list of the parts needed can be found on the hydraulic arm build guide, found on TeacherGeek.com under Documents. For this kit, you would need a pair of our TeacherGeek multi-cutters, a TeacherGeek reamer, a number 2 Phillips head screwdriver, and a pair of safety glasses. A pair of pliers and a crayon or wax are optional. Components and free documents for this activity are available at TeacherGeek.com. The TeacherGeek construction system allows you to build almost any mechanism you can imagine using two simple tools. The dowels and connector strips can be easily cut to size using our TeacherGeek multi-cutter. But don't use the multi-cutter to cut metal because you'll ruin the blade. Most of our TeacherGeek components come with holes that dowels just press into. Just twist the reamer back and forth to ream out a hole. Reaming out a hole will make it so it no longer holds a dowel. So don't ream out holes you want dowels to stay pressed into. Only ream out holes you want dowels to slide or rotate in. To build the cylinders, you will need a barrel, a plunger, a piston, some screws, and a packet of silicone. Take the plunger and set it onto the end of the piston. Apply silicone all the way around the plunger. You can put silicone in the barrel if you want, but make sure it's past this line. Then go ahead and put the piston into the barrel, move it up and down a few times to make sure the silicone spreads out. Without silicone, the plunger will stick to the end of the barrel and the piston will pull right off. And finally, add 2 number 6 screws into the barrel to keep the piston from coming out. You will need to cut 3 pieces of tubing for your hydraulic arm. You will need one that's 60 centimeters, which is about 23 inches, one that's 85 centimeters, which is about 33 inches, and one that's 115 centimeters, which is about 45 inches. At this point, you can pause the video and go and complete the optional fluid power lab. If you would like to continue with the build, just let the video play. To fill the cylinders and create a hydraulic system, the first thing you need to do is get some water. Take one of your cylinders and place it in the water. Slowly pull up to fill the whole thing with water. Attach the cut tubing to the cylinder filled with water. Push all the water out so it's filling your tubing and not the cylinder. Now take your second cylinder and again slowly pull up and fill it full of water. Attach the tubing full of water to the end of the cylinder that is now full of water. Attach a number 6 screw into the hole aside the cylinder tip. This will keep the tubing from pulling off. Your hydraulic system is finished. When making a hydraulic system that uses a 13 mm and 4.5 mm cylinder, you always want to fill the 13 mm cylinder with water first. Then just follow the previous steps using the smaller cylinder. Then go ahead and fill the 4.5 mm syringe. Attach the tubing onto the cylinder and then go ahead and push the water through. Just add the number 6 screws and you're all set. Your first step is to cut 3 sections of dowel. Cut them to 55 millimeters, which is about 2 1/8 inches. Then go ahead and push or tap the dowels into the connector strip. Using the easy cutter to tap the dowels in is the easiest way. Then take a second connector strip and set it on top. Push or tap it onto the dowels. Take your reamer and clean out both holes next to the end dowel. Cut another dowel to 150 millimeters, which is 6 inches. You should cut the dowel in half so you have two equal pieces. Slide that dowel through the holes that you previously reamed out. Now add 6 millimeters or a quarter of an inch of slide stop on each side to hold the dowel in place. Then go ahead and push or tap a perpendicular block onto each side of the dowel. Make sure that the perpendicular blocks are facing the same direction. Slide the perpendicular blocks down about 5 millimeters, which is about a quarter of an inch on each side. Place two full connector strips onto the ends of the dowels. Make sure the connector strips are facing the same direction. Take the other half of the dowel that you previously cut. This dowel should be 150 millimeters, which is about 6 inches. Then push or tap the dowel in between the end of the connector strips. Grab your hydraulic system that uses 60 centimeters of tubing, which is about 24 inches, and then go ahead and use a reamer to clean out the top hole. Again, take another dowel and cut it to 150 millimeters, which is 6 inches. And then take that dowel and slide it through the top hole of your cylinder that you just cleaned out. Then go ahead and add about 6 millimeters, which is about a quarter of an inch of slide stop on each side to secure the dowel. Slightly spread apart the connector strip so you're able to attach the cylinder. You don't have to place the cylinder into the same position I am. You can place it wherever you want. You could always change it later. Then go ahead and place the dowel into the base. Spread the connector strips slightly apart so you can push the dowel into the connector strips. Make sure your arm moves when you push and pull on your cylinder. Cut two sections of dowel to 45 millimeter, which is about 1 3/4 inches. Using those two dowels that you just cut, go ahead and push or tap them into a connector strip. Take a second connector strip and set it on top. Then go ahead and push or tap it onto the dowels. Use your reamer to clean out the four holes marked in the picture. Cut a dowel to 65 millimeters, which is about 2.5 inches. Place that dowel through the reamed hole of your connector strip. Spread out the end of the connector strips on your main arm. Place your second arm in between and push the connector strips onto the dowel. Grab your hydraulic system that uses 85 centimeters of tubing, which is about 34 inches, and then using a reamer, clean out the top hole of the cylinder. Cut a dowel to 45 millimeters, which is 1.75 inches. Then take the cut dowel and place it through the reamed hole of your cylinder, and attach about 6 millimeters, which is 1/4 inch of slide stop on each side to secure the dowel in place. Then take your cylinder and place the main body of the cylinder into your main arm. And then attach the dowel onto your secondary arm. You can place the cylinder wherever you feel works best. You can always change it later. And then make sure your secondary arm moves when you push and pull on your cylinder. And then go ahead and cut off one end of a connector strip. Cut two dowels to 90 millimeters, which is about 3.5 inches. Go ahead and tap both dowels into center holes of perpendicular blocks. Cut two more dowels to 110 millimeters, which is about 4.375 inches. Go ahead and tap both dowels into one perpendicular block. Take the other perpendicular block with the dowel in the center and ream out both holes. Slide the perpendicular blocks onto the dowel, like shown above. Using your last hydraulic system, push the dowels into the cylinder. Attach the piston to the dowel. Make sure that the piston is fully touching the dowel and that you use the zip tie to connect the top hole to the dowel. Make sure that your cylinder moves freely when you push and pull on it, and then go ahead and trim the end of the zip tie off. Take two perpendicular blocks and put them on the end of the dowel. These will act as your grippers. Place a screw into the bottom hole of your cylinder, and then to get it started, give it a few turns. Place the gripper onto the end of the connector strip and screw the screw through all the way, and then add a number 10 nut to hold it in place. Cut the tabs off the other end of the cylinders. Attach the cylinders together using the 1-inch screws and the number 10 nuts. Now that your hydraulic arm's done, go ahead and test it out. You can use various objects and try and stack them with your hydraulic arm. Now that you've played with the arm, go ahead and try and modify it, improve it, and make it your own design.